It doesn't look like it's a Husker strat.
First lifestealer pick of the weekend. And again, you
this
get a
lot
of options.
That can get on the drow, though. Like, especially at the Batrider to deliver the lifestealer. And
with
once you're on her...
Chen creeps as well.
Yeah, she ain't going anywhere.
Yeah, that's a nice... that's one thing I like. There's a... obviously, the Batrider is the more prominent initiation vehicle, but Chen can get his creeps in there and make sure that the lifestealer is always going to have something to jump in and out of.
And it can actually be a part of a pretty strong push if you, you know, get one of the big creeps and you're just the front line for the team. So they still lack damage on buildings right now. I mean, Chen's okay, but they've got a Dendi hero to address that, I imagine. So what would Dendi play? Death Prophet, maybe? We saw that get banned 5th last game.
We've seen him play Bat sometimes, but it seems
true.
Like they've kind of gotten away from that recently.
So what are we looking at for Secret here? The other support or maybe an Agi hero to pair with the Drow?
I think they need, at least one more ranged core.
Viper.
You're not really
Viper
kidding.
Is the other disgusting mid that's similar to Razor.
Yeah.
Viper versus Lifesteal is pretty good.
Or you might go back to the Shadow Demon here. Purge really screws with both Batrider and Lifestealer.
It's a slightly passive strong duo spirit. At that point.
That I did not expect.
So I think... there's just the Bat Lasso, which is countered by the Oracle, so there's no good disables to deal with Storm Spirit at all this game. So I imagine Secret's just looking at this like, this is a great game for Storm to really go off.
Yeah.
Here that benefits from the Drow Aura, so...
yeah, and most of the mid cores don't actually have that much disable anymore,
I mean, the only thing that Na'Vi like to run that comes to mind in the past was the Dendi Quap, and you could rush an Orchid with that.
No, the Death Prophet
is a lot more.
You still got the Silence and the DP.
It's like okay versus Storm, but
it's not like a
counter,
true disable.
Yeah, that's true.
I like Puck a lot more than that, but...
yeah, it's Puck. They'd rather see like a Dendi Windranger personally. They do the Windranger with
like
the roaming Chen where they max shackle by 7 and they just go for ganks with the Chen coming in.
Mm-hmm. Secret will ban the Quap. And
wow.
There's your double lasso.
The big scary thing with the Storm pick is you know how Artstyle plays and he's going to be ganking that Storm multiple times before Storm hits level 6. So I was looking at this like, okay, how can they protect the Drow and the Storm, and they just pick up two super defensive supports. Slash, it could even be a Bulba offlane. That's some NA Dota stuff right there. Offlane
right.
Abaddon.
Yeah, it could like start even as a dual lane and then transition the Axe into the jungle.
Yeah. Even if you're doing the Abaddon in the offlane, it keeps the supports busy because that's a hard hero to deal with and zone out.
Batrider is going to have a sad game, though.
We've seen SF Yules, too, kind of deal with Storm Spirit, but that's...
The Kaboom.
Yeah, it's actually surprisingly decent.
All right, so we need a Dendi hero, guys. Timbersaw still on the table. Death Prophet I still like here.
I still think their biggest issue is not being able to take objectives quickly enough yet. Chen alone is not sufficient.
Which is why I kind of go back to the DP.
I like Puck personally. But Puck hasn't won many games.
Especially when you're versus Storm with a Drow backing up. Like the armor discrepancy between Puck and Storm, and you have all the extra damage, it's going to be a tough lane. And he's got a defensive support, we'll probably be camping him.
I think you need kill potential, though, on the Storm Spirit with the Chen, or else you're kind of giving him a free lane.
Or can you just... you may even look to swap up the lane, put like a Bat mid and pick up a last pick safe laner or off laner if you feel like you need to address the Storm. Because you can run Lifesteal in the off lane as well. There's a lot of different ways Na'Vi can lane this.
Cores that mess with Storm though, are not that many.
I mean, Anti-Mage, but he's kind of bad against the others. Axe and Drow.
Yeah.
Well, Diriam it goes back a bit, but he's played that here.
That's 3 seconds.
Slaughter and Nakes is good. This is probably Dendi mid with Slaughter offlane.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there we go. That's the kind of approach where it's like, okay, we need more like firepower and damage output, so...
this is the, you're never going to get to push because we're going to run at you.
But it's not particularly good versus Abba.
How do you see the Batrider Storm lane playing out? Because that, I think, is going to be the single biggest question in the early game.
Art styles...
Storm, I think...
depends on Chen, really, more than anything there.
I think Storm has a great matchup versus Bat. You can't really dive him because of the Remnants, and then you have Drow Aura on top of that.
Yeah.
You have the threat of, like, an Oracle with, like, a Fate's Edict can easily, like, stop a Batrider from diving.
Gods, predictions, final thoughts?
I think Secret have good defensive heroes, but I like Na'Vi a tiny bit better. I think if they execute play well in the early game, if Artstyle has a good efficient game in the early game, I think Na'Vi can take game two.
Yeah, I got to go with you once again. This feels much more in Na'Vi's wheelhouse to me. This is the brand of Dota that made them, in our eyes, the favorites in this series. I think we're going to see a game three and yet again another series today. With that, let's throw it over to LD and Merlini for the cast.
Oh, thank you very much, guys. That's right. We're ready to go. Game two has begun. Players already entering the lanes in the field of battle. Puppy will be taking over that forward position. Axe already TP'd himself down bottom. We'll slap Sneko around a bit.
I like Secret's draft yet, a lot more. I think Na'Vi's draft is good for them, but it's not like a lot of things on Secret's lineup counter what Na'Vi have. So I have to give Secret the upper edge.
For me, I think the big thing is that Na'Vi have Artstyle on a hero that can take over from minute one. Last game, he was Night Stalker, couldn't do anything for the first 4 or 5 minutes. To me, that's probably where, matchup-wise, I agree, I think Secret matches up a bit better, but I just think for Na'Vi, they're a team that needs their comfort picks more so than other teams, so. Pretty close. We'll see how it turns out. They definitely need that bit of a snowball here, though, it feels like, for Na'Vi to keep this game under control. If the Storm gets ahead, there is not much to deal with him.
Or if Slaughter gets behind.
Yes.
Which I think is pretty likely in this game.
Normally we'll see Na'Vi when they run like the Sand King or the Slaughter, they will send a support to go help General in the offlane. So does he get that help this game? Does Wyvern go there? Does Chen go there? Where will they roam?
So Bulba is playing the Abba. And Puppy is on the Axe. So Abba versus Lifestealer, I actually don't think that's that bad for Abba. You can trade a lot, but I think every time you open wounds, you just shield it off, right-clicking back, no problem. You have Frostborn, or Curse of Avernus, rather, to kind of trade last hits and trade right-clicks, so I think it's a pretty decent lane for him.
So, it's going to be the Storm versus Batrider matchup here mid, and Arteezy did start with the Magic Wand, very important. Versus the Bat, not like getting caught off guard by how the lanes were set up. But no support yet for the...
Oh, they're actually putting two people on the bottom lane.
That Axe abandoned dual lane we talked about a little bit.
Yeah, we've seen Dazzle Axe, but I think this one is actually much more problematic for an Na'Vi's lineup.
Now, very importantly, we are seeing that Chen move top, so this could be what helps give the Slardar his early start that we mentioned he needed. Artstyle's gonna march in. Last time this happened, his team got 3 kills in short order, but not as easy for a Slardar to get in close as a Sand King without the boots picked up yet. The pressure is still here in the bottom lane, though. Bulba and Puppy definitely doing their part to slow down this lifesteal a little bit, and they do manage somehow to cage Pylai Dai. The double stun combo comes out. He's gonna try to eat his way through the trees. Na'Vi, true to form, give him a jungler. They'll score first blood, and they do it here again.
Pretty surprising that Pai got caught there, but yeah, that's what they need. Chen have a lot of impact.
It just seems like every time they have a jungler, somehow enemy support ends up dying. It's the Na'Vi magic.
Yeah, really need to secure that Slardar's farm, but at the same time, Axe, in the meantime, is interrupting old Ditya Ra's farm.
Dendi is having a tough time here mid, 5-3, and Arteezy, only gonna get easier for him once that bottle comes out. Definitely the Drow Aura having its impact.
It's like nearly impossible to die as a Batrider with your really crummy damage versus a Drow ranged hero. Or Drow ranged hero plus Drow.
See Puppy get zoned out a bit here. Sneko goes into long range form, but Ditya Ra also getting bullied. Being forced back, he's still CSing well. Wyvern keeping him in fighting shape as much as possible in this lane. So they're not really shutting Ditya Ra down though. Puppy is going to get onto him now. He's looking for a couple extra helixes.
That might have worked when Helix was not pure. But Puppy just ran at him instantly.
He's like, kill. Hasn't gone back to the jungle yet. And we still see up in this top lane the pressure from Na'Vi is Artstyle in general continue to pull creeps away from the tower to try and dive Envy under it. This is the same recipe that worked so well for them in past matches, but one kill, not catastrophic. It's when you start giving up those 2-3 kills and then the tower falls that things really get ugly.
Thar's even on CS though with Drow, so that's very problematic even if they aren't able to kill the support Sonaco. Trading blows with Bulba.
You can't trade with Abaddon.
Yeah, but Bulba's out of mana though, with no clarity.
Still getting his levels here though. Looks like Puppy has made his transition back to the jungle. Leaving a little more space for the Lifestealer here. Some secret. Their turn to play the greedier, more AFK farming style jungle. Has to pop the fairy fire here just to kill off the damn centaur. Die already, he says. We'll get the kill. It's the Wyvern. Suicide's the neutrals. We'll get that free fountain trip. Relatively quiet here in the early laning stage, aside from that one movement. So Teezy moves on Dendi.
This is the second time that we've seen Stormsphere start off with boots before bottle. And last game he was a Razor, so that makes a lot more sense. This game I think he actually just wanted it to play very defensively against Dendi because he knew that the supports wouldn't be able to help him out at all.
And with that, it's tough for a bat to find any sort of kills. The magic wand's already there, and then there's the boots to try and avoid getting run down by Firefly, and a storm just getting to level 6 uncontested. Which
and
is...
a haste. That's a free.
Free kill, maybe. Or get out of jail
level
free
six
card
here.
Yeah. TZ is on track. And I think we saw a storm meme earlier this event where it was like 3 or 4 deaths for the storm, though. They will force him to pop it. TZ will scurry away. But still, he's very close to it. So, overall thoughts, Ben, on the laning stage here. Slardar getting a lot, Lifestealer getting a lot. Storm and Drow also doing quite well.
About even. I think the Oracle is under like a lot of pressure, so the False Promise might not come out at a reasonable time for them, which would allow Dendi to be a lot
more. Moving on to Dendi, but they did lose the Battle Hunger, and again the Wyvern play from Sonaco coming in at the final critical moment here to save Dendi's life. Puppy being chased out by his old teammate, but top lane, that's the important action where Eternal Envy gets dove, run down, and crushed. Death by the Fish, who looks to make Pylite Eye his next victim. Runs out of sprint at the exact wrong moment, but the clap comes out. Ooh, close call for Pi. Puppy's got a TP is the reply to that.
Wow, what a great TP from Puppy. I think the General would have gotten another kill, and if he had that, he'd be like halfway to his Blink Dagger 5 minutes into the game.
Nobody expects the Axe Battle Hunger counter gank.
Nope, you do not expect that.
Yeah, it's necessary though, and Envy says, you know what, my lane sucks. Let me come bottom. Bulba, you go stop having fun top lane.
He's struggling in the level department. He's only level 4.
Yeah, I mean, when they dive him under tower like that, he gets zoned out of EXP range, and Oracle has been there sapping it a lot. As speaking of our Oracle, looks like he's just now made it home, TP'd out from the Wyvern pressure top lane. So Na'Vi, just it feels more like a traditional Na'Vi match when they've been doing well, Ben, where they're very aggressive. But Secret look to answer that aggression. The Yara has the infest. We'll barely get it off here, but he's gonna pop out with no HP. One more auto attack from Bulba, and the Frostmourne will work its magic.
Wow, yeah, that's especially good versus that Rage. Artstyle keeps finding kills on that top lane. Looks to be a death trap for any secret heroes headed that way.
It's like, who are we going to feed away this time? But secret. I mean, they're getting kills elsewhere, so.
But now they just dodge that lane and try and just control bottom.
That's easy.
Pretty good move.
Was on a little journey there, I think, expecting the bat might go to the jungle. Looking for a kill with the Invisor, not gonna happen. So he'll rotate on towards mid. So they're leaving 4 heroes down in his neck of the woods. Even Puppy making the journey, a full 5-man migration as Secret truly abandoned the top lane and the upper half of the map for greener pastures and a safer farming paradise for Eternal Envy.
And as a result, they will have to deal with a Slaughter Blink coming out very soon, but they do have the ABBA for that, the Oracle for it. Oh, he's actually going Armlet, okay. So wants to do some damage. Armlet. I guess maybe relying on the Batrider to initiate and wanting to just stay in melee range and be a nuisance to the Drow Ranger, or maybe not get cold.
How do you feel about the Secret's decision here to just send all 5 bottom and just focus on taking towers as
a
group?
That's what they need to do. If they, like, every hero that went top just keeps on dying. So
if nobody's top, nobody can die.
Yeah, don't hemorrhage them kills. They already have counters versus Slardar with the ABBA, so I don't really think that they're too concerned about him getting a lot of farm.
Sonaco's like, why are there so many heroes here, guys? I need some help. He's trapped in the trees, he goes for the TP out, and it's not gonna happen. Puppy there with the call, Secret score the kill. Though they are rather low in general, looks to punish this one. He is gonna get off that amp on Puppy, and with a lifestealer there, laning with physical damage, he'll drop quickly, but he's not finished off. The shield keeps him alive. Now working on Ditya Ra, needs help, isn't gonna get it. He too will fall. General, next man in. Also going for the armlet here, so they are really relying on the Batrider to be their initiator. But
Abba owns them though. Like, Abba owns the lifestealer and slaughter initiation. Like, who do you go on of these two melee heroes? You're just gonna get kited all day. And then, even if you are able to focus someone, you have to deal with like the axe call, the frost arrows, the gust. I don't see them being able to do that much damage. And this is where Dendi really needs to shine on the Batrider.
It's also quite unusual to see Tranquils in the armlet as well.
Yeah, that's. That was very, very strange to see. I think maybe he's just like, oh, I have a free lane. I can transition into a real core this game instead of an initiator. I want to be a real core too.
Mommy, when I grow up, I want to do damage.
Someday you will, but today is not that day. So yeah, Art Style looking for Envy here top lane. Envy, he made the mistake of coming back top end. A horrible, horrible mistake. Probably 5 secret heroes inbound to save Envy from himself, but I don't know if he's gonna have enough help. The Oracle joins the fray. Puppy there too, forcing the Chen army back. Actually gonna snare on Artstyle. Puppy though, waiting on that call cooldown. It's pretty long here.
Kill those and get level 6.
And they do rebut the aggression, but it took a lot.
So, all that time Secret spent bottom, Na'Vi weren't even able to get this T1 up top because Slaughter's just not very good at pushing the towers, and he also felt like he needed to help his team out for that bottom fight. And Na'Vi supports struggling to get level 6 with their Wyvern and Chen. Not quite there. Mars Puppy just hit his. Chen just hit his.
Dendi still engaged in the jungle wars here.
Yeah, he has actually not been that involved in fights. They really need him to, because he's like their AoE damage dealer. I guess a little bit from Wyvern, but Wyvern's a support. Like, there are two other cores can't control Secret in fights. So it's all about the, like, napalming multiple heroes, like, making the two supports, like, have to choose who they want to heal, and then you can go on the other heroes. But, like, I think that Dendi has a tall task ahead of him.
Yeah, armlet number 1 complete now. Still.
They gave it the Drow? The Tome? Wow. See that far behind? You don't see the Tome on the cores very often. I think Secret do it more often than other teams. I guess they're. Or maybe he's passing it to Pi.
Pi's like, give it back. I need it.
I need False Promise.
Come on, man. I promise I'll save you with it.
So Storm Spear's well on his way to having a very timely Bloodstone.
Normally in Na'Vi games, like, this is the point where if the game's gonna go well for them, they'll have like this little farming window, they'll get their next round of items, and then they'll just go find like 3-4 kills and go take objectives. Do you see them doing that this game, given these strong defensive supports and minimal lockdown for Storm, or?
If the Batrider controls the fight, yes. Like, if he can isolate the Oracle early on in the fight, and they can, like, control the Abba, or Abba's, like, slightly out of position, I think they can easily, like, have a 3-for-0 or 4-for-0. But I think all of it depends on getting rid of those, the two defensive heroes. Oracle is very key, just like last game.
I mean, Abaddon's not really a hero you can get rid of. Like, maybe you can cliff him in a Roche fight or something, but
they can, like, curse him if he's, like, with the other heroes.
That's true.
So I think, like, they just have to control him, and they don't have to kill him. They just need to, I don't know, maybe, like, net him to whatever it may be.
I'll be getting healed up here, but Pylite die.
So Blink Dagger up on
Dendi. And there's
Dendi. The blink. This is the time that I think they need to hit, because, like, Slaughter is actually, like, mega farmed with the Trank and the Armlet.
They've double Armlet, have Hand of God, they have the blink. This should be go time. Even the Winter's Curse is ready now, so.
Maybe waiting for a blink on Slaughter, I would say, is the one thing that they're missing, but I think it's good enough. Or else Secret are just gonna keep farming in their Ancients and jungles. And Envy again, he goes for the mask build. This is clearly the build that he prefers, and let's see what they do with the lasso.
Dendi on the hunt here. He's gonna find Bulb, but he's like, that's really not the hero I want. Blinks up onto the cliff, throws out a napalm, gets scouted there. And now the mech purchase on Chen, so nice dodge there by Secret, and quite important that it was Bulba he saw, or Dendi may have gone in.
Okay, so Wyvern finally hits 6, so he used the last hero of the 10.
But they're not... Secret are doing a good job here at dodging ganks. Like, they're not feeding kills, it's 3 to 4. They are farming quite well, the Storm especially.
Yeah, they just need to wait for a couple more items, in particular the Bloodstone and the Bleak on Axe.
Looks like they want to have another go though, the Batrider just poised in that mid lane.
Yeah, but...
But no easy targets.
They don't see the Oracle. And Abba's out in front,
so. It's a bad in farming with an Oracle behind it. Even if you see him, I don't know if you want to go in.
Their tanks are playing... I'm saying tank, but not really tank. They're frontliners, more importantly. Like, Abba this game and the Razor last game, like, he's always way out in front. So, like, he's always looking for the hero to... Like, the hero that's going to jump their backline.
Or just to reveal the smoke, like we saw bottom earlier.
I think, like, that's a very underrated part, is, like, the positioning of the frontliners. And I think Secret do it a lot better than most.
Chen gonna recall his army here. See, the Bloodstone has been grabbed. A 14-minute Bloodstone by our TZ. It's a Storm mid. Has to be one of the strongest Storm starts we've seen, despite the lack of kills.
And they've kind of rendered Batrider's early game useless. He wasn't able to really capitalize on the laning matchup in mid. He got his Blink Dagger, but he failed the first smoke pop. And then, like, would you rather have a Batrider with Blink or a Sorcerer with Bloodstone? 14 minutes of game. The answer is, like, easily a Sorcerer with Bloodstone.
Especially when there's so many counters for Lasso this game.
Yeah, so I'm very worried for Na'Vi. They need, like, a big Winter's Curse or, like, Lifesteal to get like 2 or 3 kills off the back of it and Infest Bomb.
Looking for another smoke gank. Dendi moves in. Both team smokes breaking, but Puppy is the one to get the jump here. Isolating and then quickly bringing down Artstyle on the Chen. Now Dendi moving forward. Can they finish off Artiz? He's low. He's crushed. He's dead. Na'Vi have killed him off. Now they're going to look for El Capitan as well, but gets healed up by the False Promise. There's the Winter's Curse. Locking Pylite Eye down. Gets melted by his own teammates. Great curse there from Sunako. And now Puppy's low. Can Dendi chase him out? The shield is there. Still have the Bulba, Avern, or Lord of Avernus alive, and it seems they'll disengage from there. So it ends up being a Chen down, an Oracle down, and most importantly, Storm does die. So Bloodstone charge is diminished, nice and early.
Yeah, I'm very surprised that he died that fight. The defensive heroes were controlled, and that crush from Stardar really secure. So it looks like they want to give. I think you give the Storm the Aegis this game. Because, like, especially after that one, like, you need to be able to build up Bloodstone charges. And Winter Wyvern was very patient with that ultimate, and without that many ultimates to Na'Vi's name, Secret looking to take down Roche, but he got to deal with Batrider.
Well, not having ults has never stopped Na'Vi before. Although Dendi might get stopped by Force here. Puppy finds him out with a Blink call to initiate. The follow-up comes through. Oracle trying to nuke him down, and he eventually gets him with the Purifying Flames. Last hit going to Arteezy.
I think also important note, last fight, Puppy missed his Coaling Blade. He didn't actually get the Coal on the first hero that died. I think maybe he got ticked up a little bit by the Cold Embrace and then didn't get that Coal. I think that move speed would have helped a lot, and the attack speed. Although maybe it would just been Pilot Eye's earlier demise.
Still Secret, quickly grabbing the Roshan here after getting the kill on the Batrider. Do you see 2300 gold up on Slardar, so if General wants his Blink, he's got it. But Secret, despite losing the skirmish slightly mid, they get an Aegis for Arteezy. Relatively even. Bit of an edge gold-wise to them.
What item is Bulba going for? Is he going for like a mech or what? Vlad's? Okay. I'm guessing the gloves is for Midas, but I wasn't sure whether he was going to go like an Aura build or...
What is the Abaddon build nowadays? Do you still get the Ags or...?
Ags is great. I think you get it after Vlad's, but I think the mech has a much more synergy with the Oracle. But I don't know how poor Oracle is. Looks like he is way down on the net worth.
He's like old school Pilot Eye status. Lately, he's been getting a lot, especially on the Shadow Demon.
So Puppy has a buckler, just trying to armor up all around. Very necessary versus pretty much almost all physical damage. I guess a little bit maybe from Batrider, but even versus the Winter's Curse, all this armor will help.
Oh, Bulba just going in here on the Ancient Black Dragon. He is not afraid of that thing. Though most heroes are. Throwing the shield on himself again, the Blink call from Puppy, not gonna find it. Good juke there by the Wily Dragon. Now moving forward and trying to deal with the creep wave. Slowing down the siege, allowing Na'Vi to stay in contention for this tower, but it drops extremely low even with the nukes. The spam, it's not enough. Last hit going to Arteezy again. Maintains pole position here as far as net worth goes. 8200 for him. And Secret do take an objective, but they had to work for that one.
They're getting a lot with, like, their Aegis, their early farm, the Drow, I think. So I think it's going pretty decently for Secret. Na'vi, they still have huge upside, though, with their heavy, heavy burst, and Winter's Curse almost certain to eliminate a target from the fight, so...
Now that Secret have Aegis, they're farming. Na'vi appear to be mostly trading farm. Does that just favor Secret straight up if it's a farm war? Is there a way Na'vi can handle that?
Just better execution in fights. Like the Blink Lasso or Blink Stomp with the Infest Bomb can kill Oracle. Oracle is, or even Storms here, like we saw die last fight. So they just need to be able to hit their AoE. They have, like, I think much more upside in fights than Secret, whereas Secret they have to kind of play as a tight ball like last game and have heroes sit behind each other and work together.
How annoying is that? The call completely countered out there by a timely embrace. Diarado is forced to run. Bulba just man-moding his way in. This is looking like that Arteezy Alchemist game from yesterday. But Diarra will pop the Rage and look to turn around on the backside. Storm is going in deep, trying to find pickoffs. Arteezy retreating out. Diarra low. Does get cursed, controlled for now. Also, Bulba held in position, but they're not finding kills during that Winter's Curse. Oracle low, but the chase goes on. Arteezy continue to lay in with the damage. He will get focused, brought down. Almost, not quite. False promise there. Keep him alive. Diarra forced to eject. Gets into a creep. Pops right out. Very low. Armlet toggle, not gonna happen. Puppy chops him down, and Arteezy still has the damn Aegis. Someone kill this man, they just can't do it. He's healed right back up. He's gonna buy another Oblivion Staff, and Team Secret just bulldozing their way through Na'vi.
They didn't get the Aegis?
Oh, Na'vi brought their tractor, but Secret brought a demolition crew. And they took the air out of the wheels of that tractor.
They need a way better Winter's Curse. The Winter's Curse did not get the Drow Ranger, so... No one died during it. I don't even really think that was any damage during the Winter's Curse.
Well, Secret will probably have to let it go here and take the tier 2, but they're very happy with that exchange.
Let it go. There's no CM in the game.
I saw that movie recently.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
First time? It's a good movie.
It was good. I'm not quite getting the level of hype.
As Fog, I hear Fog just like bust out voice lines from those songs.
Oh, is he gonna sing for us later?
Please do.
Fog, are you gonna sing for us later?
Are you gonna sing us some Frozen?
Some Frozen. Do you want to build a snowman, Yannis?
We watched
probably not in this weather.
We watched it at like Summit 4 or Summit 5? Summit 3? I mean,
no, Summit 1 at the after party.
Summit 1?
You guys all turned it on the TV and you just wouldn't, like, you kept on singing the entire movie. I had not seen it, so I didn't get the hype, but anyway. Memories of Summit Pass, but on track here at Starlander, Team Secret, they get the Midas for Abaddon.
So, again, they like to keep their options open, like, they're not all ending with the mech on the Abba. I think if they get that, like, you're committed to fighting a lot more, whereas, like, the Vlads, you can farm up a lot more yourself. It still helps resolve their physical damage, and Arteezy may get a
Chamber and Storm, oh my god, that's annoying. A lot of spam, but Arteezy, if he gets stunned here... He may die twice.
They need a lasso.
They have the lasso ready. There's a bit of a windup with that Storm Ball Lightning, and it's not going to be a quick enough one. Arteezy has overextended. No, he gets out on just a shrivel of HP. Calculated, Ben. Calculated.
Space created?
Bulba's happy.
Yeah, Bulba's happy. Once he gets a Scepter, though, like... Scepter is going to be a pain. I don't know if he's going Scepter, but that's typically the build for Abba's.
That could not have been closer, and that would have been a really bad death too, now that he's finally just climbed back to around the original Bloodstone charges.
I've seen Abba's also get Solar. I think Solar is really good versus all their, like, single target on their physical damage cores, so I also wouldn't mind seeing that. But, like, as an Abba, you have to make yourself a threat. You have to make it, like, to the point that you're so annoying that the opponents have to go on you. And a way to do that is, like, have all these auras that, like, the longer he's alive, the more you're getting mileage out of him. But... I don't know if it's getting to that point yet for Bulba.
So I was going to bring this up earlier, because I have seen it on occasion, but Orchid Lifestealer can be a way to deal Storm. Looks like that's what we're headed for here.
Is he going Orchid?
I think that was him, right? The double Oblivion Staff on the Lifestealer? Yeah.
Wow.
So there will be that window, I guess, where you... Now they can reliably kill him until he gets either BKB or maybe Lincoln's.
He's also really good versus the Abba. Like, easy way to take him out of the fight is just Orchid him and then focus down whomever else. So that's It will require a lot of coordination fights, like you want to lasso Oracle and then like Orchid, Abba, or the Storm, or whoever it may be. But it's a very risky build. Like you could easily just lose two fights, then the Orchid is useless because they have a lot of items to deal with it. Maybe Lotus Orb, let's say, from Puppy, because Puppy does like to build that.
Yeah, or, I mean, Pelt Bulbuk, you got one with the raid he's farming. With that might just picked up.
I don't think you actually want it on them just because I think like
he's a likely Orchid target.
Well, I think you just prefer Scepter. If you have 4,000 gold, actually, yeah, then you can't.
The Scepter is ridiculous on a bad.
Yeah, Scepter is.
I know Fogg is a big fan of that. Carried us in some pub games. We were heavy, but the Scepter was strong. Yeah. So Team Secret, they'll start to congregate here top lane. Four grouping up, looking for the push. Meanwhile, Drow Ranger scurrying to join her team. Envy wants to congregate now, and Secret will look for that tier 1 tower. Do you see Navi contesting this? Like, at what point are they actually trying to fight? Because they are getting out farmed, they're losing map control.
About right now, because Roshan number 2 is about to spawn, and they had a lot of trouble dealing with Aegis number 1. I think Aegis number 2 is going to be even more rough for them, and I don't know, if a fight goes poorly for them though, like the Orchid, he's gonna give him no survivability at all, he could just easily melt into a drow in a fight, and they might lose a gem, so they have, like, this next fight could be the one.
Blink call, catches out too, big jump in from the Storm, and he goes straight onto the back lines looking for Sonaco, but Arteezy gets ambushed here by the Orchid, doesn't matter, he's got the supports required to keep him in fighting shape, the false promise there, still the curse, follows this up, Arteezy low and will pop in the end, the combo brings him down, another death for the Storm, he's played well, but he seems to find ways to die regardless now, Envy trying to clean up on the backside here, but he's so damn squishy, Dityara just chunks them down, Bulba low, Puppy falling too. Is that Storm going to be back in time to maybe salvage the rest of the fight? He's up in 3 seconds. Puppy trying to retreat out, but they keep on nuking him down. Three heroes hit the deck. Navi find their critical timing for the team fight. They keep the Storm Bloodstone charges in check, and they get their farm back up with those kills.
Well, Orca Kanata come out at a better time. Arteezy did not expect that one, and that baited out the False Promise early, which led way to an excellent Winter's Curse by Sonaco, finishing off Arteezy, and that was a fight that they need. Now they're
Big fight that was.
That was a very big one.
Financially, that was pretty brutal for Secret.
Their strength cores are actually like not dying at all. Like they don't have enough physical damage to burst through these armlets. So
the double armlet is paying off. Not to mention they have the mech now, the Hand of God. And
so what's Bulba gonna get?
And there's a Solar Crest too.
Yeah, the Solar Crest is very problematic. Like it's, heroes drop too quickly for their like second set of like aquatic shields and whatnot.
It's not often you'll see a team with an Oracle and an Abaddon lose in a war of sustain, but I think Navi might just have the tanks and the regen needed to do it.
Yeah, Chen will also have Scepter very soon too, so like the sustain is going to be even more ridiculous once he gets like golems and dragons.
All kinds of terrifying nightmarish creatures.
Are they ever going to add the
fourth one? What is it again?
I don't know. I call them like, what, dragon spawns?
Dragon spawns. Oh, that's right. That's right. Dota 1 feels like a distant memory at this point.
I remember exactly what they look like. I don't remember their names though.
I'm pretty sure if people had to choose though, they'd probably rather have Pitlord first, wouldn't you say?
Yeah.
That you had to think about that for a second. I don't think many of our viewers would.
I was thinking like, who would actually want those ancients to be in? And I was like, Shadow Fiend players.
Oh, Puppy gets caught out here. Now they're also gonna isolate Bulba. They crush him. They silence him. Arteezy's got to engage, but General kept alive. These cold embraces on point from Sonaco. Bulba as the ultimate ends. Will continue the chase. He's got to run. He blinks out to safety. They only get the axe out of that. Could have been worse.
They have to kill this Winter Wyvern. The Cold Embrace is, like, ridiculous versus their lineup. They cannot burst through that. And Winter's Curse has proven to be the death of a couple of heroes for Secret. So they need to be able to jump in with the Orchid on the Storm Spirit. Like, the Strength Gorge are just not high priority in the fights.
Navi are confident after that. They have the Slardar, they have the Roshan potential, and they're going to use it. Moving into the pit, will Storm jump? Will Arteezy go for a big swag play here? Does he try to steal that Aegis? He zips over the pit and out of there. He still has some mana left to work with. Trying to soften them up, keep the vision strong, but Deira's already grabbed the Aegis, the Haste rune, going to the Batrider. They do pull him in. Arteezy, can he finish the job though? Denny's a bit too healthy. He's sent home all kinds of backup, but it does leave Artstyle barely isolated here. The Winter Wyvern curse already deployed. Now Artstyle on the run. Arteezy out of mana, but do they have anyone to focus him? Deira, it's the North, a very chaotic fight from Na'Vi, but finally Deira gets on to Pylite. I will mangle that Oracle, bring him down though. He is likely going to pay. Armlet toggling for all he's worth. He'll lose the Aegis. Can he get out on round number two? They've, I think, got a Berserker's call. A bit low on Mana Puppy as though. And with that call, with that extra lockdown, Deira will end up going down, try for the four staff to save him. But Na'Vi lose an Aegis and lose three. Pretty damn good hold by Secret.
Yeah, they didn't want to fight without Puppy. And Puppy was very instrumental in winning that fight for Secret. Drow Ranger was left unchecked for most of the fight and was just able to right click people down, even though they didn't have the vision that they needed. Abba also survived for a long time. That damage with Curse of Avernus and Drow Ranger really ends up.
Oh, all but going in here, and it is going to be Ags, it looks like, grabs the point booster.
Look at his farm, he's third on network. You do not see Abba's like transition this well from like offlaner to, I guess, kind of carry now. He's like within 2,000 of Drow Ranger. That's absurd.
Secret do seem to favor that one extra Midas a bit more than most teams. Like, we've seen Puppy doing a lot in the Enchantress. We see Bulba doing it here on the Abaddon.
I think it's important, though, that they don't keep giving Bulba the same things. I think one of the biggest strengths of Secret is their versatility and giving him Tidehunter every game or just
Darkseer, yeah.
Or a teamfight hero, yeah, in general, I think, is It's good in a lot of situations, but sometimes you gotta expand out, and Bulba showing that he's a flexible offlaner.
What do you think Puppy's going for here? Is that a Crimson Guard underway with the Buckler?
I think Lotus. Lotus is amazing.
Okay.
And, like, I think they need even more save because Storm Spirit has been, like, kind of, like, he isn't free to roam these fights. He's still worried about dying a lot. And I think with the Lotus Orb to dispel the Orchid, or to dispel the Orchid on the Abba so that Abba can shield him up, will allow them to win the fights. But what other items are there? I don't think Crimson Guard is that great because they, like, have really large instances of damage, which Crimson does not really help that much versus...
And they're usually doing one target at a time as well, so...
Yeah. Oh, what else could he get? Blade Mail is not particularly good.
It feels like, quite late for a blade mail.
Yeah. What else is there? BKB and not an option. He can go AC to Halberd. Halberd is actually a good choice too. I think Halberd or Lotus would be my two options on Axe.
Alright, let's see what Puppy wants in the end.
He bought something.
Spent a bit of gold here.
Did he buy Crimson? Okay.
Ah.
He does like his teamfight items. We see him go Pipe and Crimson a lot.
Yeah, it's definitely a war of sustain right now with the Chen Eggs and the Crimson coming out.
You already get a little bit extra armor from Buckler, which is why I don't prefer Crimson so much, but if you're just trying to outlast, like, Crimson plus Abba ult with Eggs, like, no one should die.
Well, for Na'Vi's sake, I bet they're hoping that's not the case. But the Eggs is almost upon us. Gonna be interesting to see if Na'Vi can actually find those quick bursty kills that they've been racking up until this point.
What did Drow get after her Yasha? Did she come to a Manta? Okay. Manta is often the item of choice against Sardar as a position 1 range to dispel the amp, but I wasn't sure if she was going to go for it because of their defensive heroes. Butterfly, I think, would have been a pretty decent option for Envy.
Well, Team Secret getting a little more confident in their pushing here. At least Bulba is. He's quite far out.
Yeah, it's Blink Dagger. Should be okay.
Dendi hunting through the jungle. He's gonna do a spot of dewarding here. They have picked up a gem now. BOT is also online, so that's the one thing Na'Vi have this game they had a bit less of last time, was the mobility to get around the map and prevent split push as much as possible. Now you've got the Lifestealer bombs, the Slardar, who can pretty much be everywhere. Even the Chen army can be pulled around a bit. See the E-Blade under construction though, and man, what a great game for it. All physical damage from Na'Vi. Shotgun is going to be very nice defensively.
Yeah, it's also somewhat of a counter to Winner's Curse. I've seen it a few times, but I don't know if it's worth committing 5,000 gold for it. Maybe casual Ghost and a Butterfly. Like, she's often like left free in these fights because most of the time they're using their spells to control the Storm Spirit. So I think that's when the Drow Ranger needs to up her damage output to compete with the Lifestealer and the Slardar.
Secret are on the hunting mission. Puppy's gonna go in, gets the two-hero call to start things off, then the Storm jumps in on the backside, gets off the Sounds of Seneca. There won't be a Winter's Curse here too early. Arteezy, do they find this first kill? He's not dead just yet. The Cold Embrace saves him. Now they look for the turn. There's the curse working on Arteezy. Can they finish the job? He's gonna be low after this. Not dead yet, though. The False Promise comes out, keeps him alive. Then Envy gets dragged back behind enemy lines. They are focusing the Drow down. The Dragon as well turned against him, but again, the follow-up calls. He's immolating. He turns on the Ghost Scepter. That just causes him to die a bit quicker. Storm still going hard in the back lines. They have brought down the Lifestealer, but General is healthy. Bulba may need to turn around now. The crush onto him, the chase onto Arteezy. They want to get that extra kill. Bulba, two will die, and General now smacking down Pi. Will he have a crush in time? He will. That's three. And Na'Vi, so close to just getting cleaned up there. They got off the curse. They kept the Lifestealer alive for a second round of engagement, and they were able barely to turn the fight.
The missed dunk again. On Secret, that was really close to starting off really well for Secret.
You know, for such a tall guy.
Yeah, can't dunk, man. Not successful.
White man. But still, Puppy's calls have been on point this game, even if the dunks have rimmed out here and there.
That was so close.
Yeah.
Heart on Slardar, so
good luck killing him now.
Yep. Cold Embrace is going to heal ridiculous amounts of HP from him, and just so much sustain too. They have like the Magda Axe to aid Na'Vi in assisting that Lifestealer without the help of the Winter Wyvern there. Dire's bottom
tower is under attack. So, with the pace of the game, it does seem to have slowed down. We're not seeing anyone just crush their way towards the enemy base, very even as far as net worth goes. Do you favor either team going late game, Ben? Is there a particular like point that the matchup hinges on, or
no, not particularly?
How do you evaluate the lineups?
I think a lot of it is like Secret being able to kill someone before Na'Vi uses their defensive abilities, and Na'Vi like trying to control up the Storm Spirit and get their big melee heroes up on the Drow Ranger. I think the later and later it gets, I think I prefer Na'Vi's a little bit more because of how well the Slardar has farmed. He is the position one in terms of just straight up net worth right now. And
Bulba, you mentioned how he's out in front scouting out these ganks.
Yeah, he is. Like, I like his positioning a lot in these fights, and now he sees a dragon, so.
And he will see that raiding party, but, oh, Batrider also getting caught out here. Dendi's out a bit far from the team. Where's the backup? He says he's embraced. He's healed up by the Hand of God, but they had to commit that all early. And then the curse onto Arteezy. He's pretty much out of mana at this point. They're using this time to focus on Bulba. He has to pop his ultimate. Envy for now, healed up, kept alive, but General's gotten onto him. This little Drow Ranger is no match for the Angry Fish. General with just one more crush will finish the job. It's actually an auto attack that finishes him, and now Bulba could well be next. Secret getting routed. It's Na'Vi again. Three heroes dead. Teezy ran out of mana pretty quickly that fight. Had to just run away.
Dang, Seneca with the saves.
This and Wyvern.
Art style, too. Yeah, the Chen Heal like, bought enough time for Wyvern to come in with Cold Embrace. And
it looked really bad for Denny. He was horribly in deep. No support in sight, but it ended up being salvaged there in the end.
Drow also wasn't that close to them. Like, they were all split up. Their strength is in numbers. Although maybe they don't want to like group up too much because of the Winter's Curse, but like they cannot split up like that. The Abba was not able to save the Drow Ranger, nor was he able to save the Storm Spirit.
The Oracle died pretty early as well.
Yeah. And
big dive by Arteezy, and then quickly back to the well. Slowly farming here, gets the ultimate ore, but the item progression has really slowed down for both teams, and I think that's to Na'Vi's liking, given what they've already picked up.
Oracle's so poor.
Puppy's about to be a little poorer himself, as Na'Vi delete him. Not on his own. That's an important hero to be bringing down. Just leaves the Lifestealer free to roam in these fights, and what do you know for Na'Vi? Roshan about to come back up. Any second now, Seneca just poking his head in a bit too early, doesn't see the Rosh, so Na'Vi say, hey, we'll go high ground instead. But there is a buyback on Puppy. The crush hitting Bulba first, then the Shiva's follow from Denny. They're trying to force out this Abaddon ultimate nice and early. Are they going to commit any further on him? General, look at the HP on this man. He is just shrugging off the Envy auto attacks. Fears nothing. Dragon and Triceratops slow sieging this tower, and it is slow, mind you. Na'Vi are not very good at killing buildings.
Chen right-clicking the tower.
He's like, come on, guys, you can do it, just a little more damage! but it's slow.
They would have been able to take Roche already had they not gone for that, though. So it was like very unfortunate for Na'Vi that the Roshan respawned like maybe 5 seconds after they checked. And now Axe will have a chance to join up the fight, and Storm Spirit always has the potential to make big plays around the Roche pit, as does Batrider, as does Wyvern.
Who's gonna be the hero? Who's gonna be the zero? Na'Vi looks like they might get the jump. The Blink Crush is there, only catching out one, but it's Puppy. Isolated, doesn't get off this call until much later in the fight, and then all hell breaks loose with Dendi caught in the middle. He'll quickly drop General, very tanky though. Arteezy running out of mana, he's gonna have to disengage soon, and then Envy will get turned on real quick. The curse is there, holding Arteezy in position. The Ghost Scepter under the trees. Envy not auto-attacking though. Can they clean up? Yeah, Ra, Isolated dead next, and it seems like Team Secret holding their own in this fight. Two down, about to be a third. Artstyle drops as well. Envy never dying, and Secret hanging on with the Roshan. Now theirs to be claimed.
Wow, Eternal Envy kited the crap out of them right there.
Speaking of kiting, Ben, look what he just bought.
Wow,
that's the four staff.
He did an excellent job there. He like almost back off into the Winter's Curse, and then he used a Ghost Scepter to kite the Lifestealer, which allowed enough time for Puppy to come back in. I actually think like Puppy was the one who survived for way too long in that fight. He dropped down very, very early on, but nice positioning by Arteezy. I think like Arteezy, he can't really jump into the fight early. I think he needs to wait for that, like wait for them to commit just a little bit too much and then jump the Na'Vi supports. And Dendi died. Yeah, I thought that it was going to be a good fight for Na'Vi because they had an Observer Ward. They blew up the Oracle like within half a second with the start of the fight with General on top of him.
It wasn't the best focus fire from Na'Vi that fight. Slardar blinked in, he crushed the Axe, then they changed targets, they cursed the Storm, but nobody was damaging him during that time. Envy got focused a little bit, then Ghost Scepter and ran away, so Na'Vi just, they didn't have like that clean instant pickoff as we've seen in other engagements. But speaking of instant pickoffs, Pileidai playing the role of the Dire this game. 2700 net worth. The next closest, 9700. That is a pretty big discrepancy here. Arteezy duking out a bit with General, but General very tanky. Not the easiest hero to focus down first. Instead, he's going to look for Dendi. He gets him. Good save there by Sineko, but at the same time, Dendi's been kept in position. The curse onto Envy, but there's nobody hitting him. It's fairly ineffective. And then the blink call. They're going to find the Batrider. They're looking for Sineko as well, and I'll trade Pileidai for those two kills any day of the week.
Now Storm Spirit with an extra layer defense. Actually, two extra layers with the Lincolns and the Aegis. They're going to have a much more difficult time locking him down. I don't really think like a Lifestealer wants to pop the Lincolns with an open wounds or a Bloodthorn. Then I don't think Wyvern has the force to pop it, and the Splinter Charge often just takes far too long to actually get to him. So now Storm Spirit has a lot more space to roam around these fights. And that was a big loss. I believe Dendi was possessing the gem.
Now Secret trying to take advantage of this one, pushing a bit further, working on creeps here for Arteezy. Gonna clear this wave out, and they will begin their siege. Also worth mentioning, they've got the Frost Armor creep as well, which really helps mitigate this physical damage. You can see Envy very diligent to apply it on teammates as well as himself. They'll bring the tower down. Secret, it's been back and forth, but now they're starting to seize momentum. They get a blink call and Arcstyle deep behind his own tier 4s. They're trying to give Na'Vi the Na'Vi treatment, but where they differ is they'll just use that blink call to zone, then they'll back. Blink Crush comes out onto Arteezy. Will there be a turn? Deyera focusing him down a bit, but remember, he's got the Aegis. It's a lot to commit on Arteezy when he's got a second life to work with. The Lasso gets quickly Oracle False Promised off, and now General on his own as the BKB. Envy standing his ground. He's just not taking damage this roll. Now he is, but the False Promise keeps him in fighting shape. Envy will survive. So much committed, not even getting the Aegis on Arteezy, then not quite able to kill off Envy. Can they focus him down with round two? General going in, but the blink call drags him back. Somebody kill this freaking Eternal Envy. General says, I want help. I need help. He's just not getting it. Plink by plink, inch by inch, slowing him down, but it does leave his teammates alone. Bulba's like, guys, can somebody help me in the front lines? That's not going to happen until Arteezy shows up. We'll get the second kill of the fight. The Slardar finally drops. Ends up being an Aegis now expended, but they got their lane of racks, and they keep their prized Drow Ranger alive.
This is the first game that I've been like really impressed with Secret's teamwork. There were like a lot of small things that fight, like the Oracle. He didn't want to use the Fortune's End he didn't want to use False Promise on Arteezy. He actually just dispelled the Bloodthorn with his Fortune's End, and that allowed him to do a lot more, save his False Promise for Envy, who ended up doing a lot of damage in the fight. They like masterfully kited General on a Slardar with the help of the Fate's Edict, like, and Puppy consistently getting good calls into the fights.
Well, I think the biggest the biggest question mark coming into this event was, how will the new Secret look? How will the new EG look? We had not seen them in a major event. Only the online qualifiers, and especially for EG, weren't really tested there. EG knocked out in two series. Secret looking strong and on the verge of a 2-0 versus Na'Vi.
Yeah, top-notch teamwork in this game.
So it appears that they may be headed different directions on the march to TI, with this being the last marquee event before the teams rotate to Seattle. This is the kind of momentum you want to have going into the TI. EG, the opposite direction. BKB now grabbed for the axe, so Puppy doesn't have to worry about those silences anymore. And there is a Bloodthorn complete on Deira, so wants to deal with the evasion, I guess.
Yeah, but he like doesn't have that much tankiness anymore. Like, he has to rely on Wyvern and like the auras a lot more than his own innate tankiness. It does give him a lot of attack speed so he can feast, but like, he has trouble sticking onto targets because he has very little move speed. Like, even the bash isn't going to help that much because he just can't right-click people during the open wounds.
And now a Lotus on Bulba. So they've now added a Lotus, a Lincoln's to their arsenal, as well as the Abaddon Ags. They have gotten much more difficult to burst. But and now we find that critical opening, though. They immediately jump in straight onto Arteezy, trying to focus him down, but he's kept alive. There's the Witcher's Curse, keeping Bulba in position, but Puppy with the BKB doesn't care about it. Arteezy onto Sinego in the back. We'll finish off that pesky old Wyvern, the False Promise. Dilithium now the turn onto Deira, who, as you mentioned, is not particularly tanky. Can they bring him down? The Life Dealer will fall next to Artstyle. Secret massacring Na'Vi. Three have fallen. They have lost nobody. And they'll even kill these creeps off too.
That was so close by them though. They tried all in onto Arteezy, but Bulba popped his ultimate. He even got it before the Winter's Curse, and then the False Promise coming out on Storm Spirit after Na'Vi had used their initial volley of spells. And Na'Vi typically have a lot of fight left, and Secret did not rest for one bit despite being two racks up, knowing that Na'Vi, they like to come back swinging, but I think that's the last swing that they're gonna get.
Well, Dendi, he said Na'Vi is back, but little did he know that Secret are too. And they look as fearsome as the Secrets of old, perhaps, albeit a small sample size thus far, but the small sample size is about to take them into the grand finals. They'll get to sit back, await their final opponent, and rest up for that best of five match. Unless Na'Vi have the answers now, they'll try for it. The last one, Puppy, but Arteezy going in deep, trying to focus down Sinego, has become his worst enemy at this point. He'll back off, look to retreat. Drow Ranger focusing General, who just doesn't feel like a hero when he's being slowed down and kited this much. So much farm, so much HP, but very little way to get in the fight and do something. Even through the Winter's Curse, Arteezy survives. And now Puppy blinking forward, going for the finishing blow here. Will he hit that last Cully Blade? There's the dunk that we've been waiting for. And with that, Secret wipe out 4. They'll take the game. They'll take the series. They'll take a guaranteed top 2 finish here at StarLadder.
I think that's the best game we've seen from Secret all tournament. Like, in terms of like not making that many mistakes and high level play, everyone helping out each other, itemization, and
all smiles, all clapping.
They should
happy
be happy. They should be very happy with this.
So they look almost relieved, I would say.
Like, within the grand finals, they get a day off. Or actually, they don't get a day off.
They don't get a day off, but they get a match off, and they get to rest, to feel good going into the last day.
And going into TI.
Well,